Sorry for the inconvenience. Kindly don't try to become the host or give the permissions to the lecturer when he joins. Okay. It will be very difficult if you join and leave. Okay, fine. So, as I was discussing, in the past classes, we have studied many concepts. Okay. For example, we studied what is data mining and what is data warehouse. Both are very, very important concepts. You know, what is the meaning of a data warehouse? You should never forget these things. Okay. Data warehouse is nothing but it's a subject oriented, okay, and integrated. That is TINS. Do people remember the TINS? Okay. Time variant, integrated, and non volatile, and subject oriented kind of data. Okay. Where we are just going to help the management to make the decisions. This is how the things goes. Okay. So then comes data mining. Data mining is more than it's a combination of art and science. Okay. So what it is going to do, it is going to discover some knowledge and insights. From this data mining, we are going to ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಲಿಂಕ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಸರ್, ನೀವು ಫೋನ್ ಹಚ್ಚಿದ್ವಲ್ಲ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಹುಡುಗರು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಹಾಂ ಸರ್, ಹುಡುಗರು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಸರ್. ಹಾಂ ಸರ್, ಹಾಂ ಸರ್, ಅದು ಹೆಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ ಸರ್? ಓಕೆ, ಫೈನ್. So I was discussing with respect to data mining. People know data mining is an art and it's a science of discovering knowledge, insight, and patterns in the data. Okay. So basically from data mining, what we are going to do is we are going to acquire the knowledge. What is the meaning of a knowledge? Is something I am going to find that is called as a knowledge. Okay. Using this knowledge, I'm going to keep on finding the content and I'm going to filter that content and use. I'm given the best example of Amazon, where Amazon is having more than 4 products. Products in it, and whenever I apply the filter, automatically based on my knowledge, it is going to start to give me the data. That is nothing but called as a data mining. Okay, so we studied about these things, and now when we are going to evaluate the data mining results, what happens when we are going to evaluate the data mining results? So suppose suppose a data mining project has been initiated, okay. So what happens? We are going to initiate a data mining project. Okay, what's going to happen in case of a data mining project? Any pattern will be there. Any predictive model will be there. Based on that predictive model, we are going to decide on the data. Okay. So for example, if I am having a cancer patient data. Okay. So where I am going to apply some predictions for the cancer patient, and I am going to make through the decision tree. So now what happens, whenever they apply the model, there will be some sort of variables. When a true positive data come across and the prediction is correct, we call it as a true positive. Okay. So when true negative data point is classified and negative that is true, then we are going to call it as negative. Okay. So when a true positive data point is classified, but still the result is negative, then we are going to call it as false negative. And when a true data is classified, okay, to be negative and the result is positive, then we are going to call it as a false positive. This matrix, whatever is there, we are going to call it as confusion matrix. And if one can see here the diagram of confusion matrix, where we are having negative positive and positive negative, okay. So when predicted class is true, when we are going to have true positive, both positive positive, and both negative and negative, we are going to call it a true negative. But even though if it is predicted class is negative, okay, and true class is positive, we are going to call it as a false negative. And when predicted class is positive and the true class is negative, we are going to call it as a false negative, false positive. Okay, so then the above formula, what I can say, mining results is been made as a predictive class. Okay. So what happens, thus the predictive accuracy can be specified by using the formula. Okay, by using the formula. What we are going to say, predictive accuracy is equal to, okay, true positive plus true negative, okay, divided by true positive plus true negative plus false positive and false negative. Okay, so when we try to find out the accuracy, sometimes the accuracy highest level is 100%. And even in some cases, the accuracy level is 70%. This is how the things goes. Okay, so when I come for data mining techniques, okay, so data may be mined to help make more efficient decisions. Okay, so if I take this concept of data mining, what is the purpose of a data mining? Why we are going to do the data mining? The main purpose of the data mining is to provide the efficient decisions. Okay, so in this, what happens when we are called a supervised learning? Basically, you know what is the meaning of a supervised learning? The supervised learning is nothing but it's a type of classification that is going to work on the past data. And we use basically this in machine learning and statistical techniques. Okay, when I say machine learning, obviously we go for decision trees and ANN. And when I say statistical techniques, regression. When I go for unsupervised learning, again, I go for some machine learning techniques where I am going to use cluster analysis and association. What this is all about, we are going to see in upcoming slides. Okay, so the most important class of problem is solved by using data mining. Okay. Where what we are going to do is we are going to take the prediction data. Okay. Okay. So what we are going to do is we are going to take the past data. Okay, we are going to mine that data. Okay, and we are going to frame some rules and patterns. Okay, that would help me to do the accuracy of the decision making process. And next is what we are going to do. We are going to develop some equations. That is nothing but in the past only we have developed some equation. If people can see here, what is that equation? TP plus TN divided by TP plus TN plus FP plus FN. Like this, we are going to develop the equations. Okay, which is going to calculate me the accuracy. Okay, and the classification techniques are always supervised learning. Why? Because this model predicts what is right and what is wrong. So then obviously we are going to do supervising there by using this model. So this is nothing but supervised learning. Okay. So when I come for decision tree, you people know decision tree is the output of data mining. Okay. Whenever I am doing the data mining, what happens? We are going to get a decision tree. That is an output we get when we are doing a data mining. Okay. So what is this decision tree? Obviously decision tree is nothing but it's a hierarchical, organized, branched. Okay, so people can see here, this is the best example of a decision tree. Okay, organized, branch, structured to help make the decision in easy and logical manner. Okay, so what happens whenever the output comes in terms of a decision tree? Now, I don't know the whole data. Are you understanding? Just I want to see the abstract of the data. So when I'm seeing the abstract of the data, the best thing I get when I see the abstract of data is nothing but decision tree. Okay, so this is what get me a clear picture. Rather than the whole data. In the same fashion, when I see the advantages of the decision tree are easy to understand and very easy to use. Okay. And even they select most relevant variables automatically. That is the beauty of the decision tree. Okay. Instead of many variables, it will select the relevant variables automatically. And they are all tolerant of data quality. Yes. Okay. And even they are having non-linear relationships. Can be handled very easily by means of a decision trees. Okay, so this is one example of a decision tree. People can see outlook here. What the outlook I get whenever I'm reading a weather data. Okay, some forecast if it is yes or sunny, yeah, high, no, normal, yes. Okay, rainy, windy season if I'm having. If it is rainy and wind is less, yes, and wind is more, no. Like this, I can get a decision tree based on the what I can say, a decision tree based on my data mining results. Okay, so now what happens? We are going to study about regression. You know, people have seen regression here. Okay, so regression. Again, it's a statistical technique. Even we studied about decision tree, which is part of a machine learning, supervised learning. So we study regression, we studied ANN, then we study about cluster analysis and association. We are going to study all these important data mining techniques. Okay. So, you know, whenever I do data mining, the output will be a decision tree. And when you are applying regression, let us see what is going to happen. Okay. So regression is a relatively simple and the most popular static data mining technique. Okay, so what is the meaning of this static data mining technique? Okay, basically it is going to a regression analysis technique where the observation of the data are molded by some functions. Okay, and even some functions may be non-linear functions. Okay, where the data, whatever the data variables we are having, they will be independent. Okay. So what happens now in case of statistical data mining technique, the very much goal is to fit a smooth, well-defined curve of the data. We get a very good curve of the data. Whenever we're plotting a graph, the data curve should be very clear. That is how regression will help. Okay. And even regression analysis techniques, for example, can be used to model and predict, okay, some kind of energy conversion functions based on some daily temperatures. Okay. So that is what here they are showing. The relationship between weight and height. Okay, now when I apply the regression technique, I can very easily find out the height will be in centimeters and weight will be in kgs. Then what I got an output is nothing but y is equal to 0.2811x plus the sum of both 13.9, which will be double. Okay, then I get a curve, very clear curve. Okay, this is how the regression technique works. Okay, so then coming back to ANN. Artificial neural network, okay, which is a very sophisticated data mining technique, okay, from the artificial intelligence. What is the meaning of the artificial intelligence? It is going to do the mimic of human behavior. It's going to try to see how human works. There is nothing but artificial network, okay. So what happens now? There will be a neurons, okay, which is going to receive some information, stimuli, okay. Process them and try to communicate the results with other neurons successfully, and eventually your neuron output is always a decision and a correct output. Okay, so what happens, a decision task may be processed by just one neuron or it may be communicated to many neurons, and finally one neuron is going to get the output. Okay, so basically what happens, this communication between one neuron to another neuron is intermediated. Okay guys, can you see here, if this is my one neuron, okay, and we are having one more neuron, okay, this two neuron is going to communicate, and that communication is intermediated, and even one neuron is going to give the feedback to the another neuron. Based on that, whatever the output comes, it is nothing but called as decision. This output is, okay, fine, let me draw something. Okay, this output, whatever you get, is a decision output. This is neuron 1, this is neuron 2, they both communicate, and this it is called as intermediate communication. Okay, and even the feedback is going to be given from one neuron to another neuron. Okay, after that they are finally, one neuron is going to give you the result. Okay, so such a technique, since it is going to have everything happens intermediate, we even call this technique as black box system. Why? Because you doesn't see anything, everything happens internally. Okay, so this is about artificial neural network. And even if people can see, if there are different N neurons, okay, they are going to communicate with one individual neuron, and then finally that neuron is going to give me the result, which is going to become a sum of all the neurons. Okay, we get a output. Right, so this is how the things works. So we call it as a black box because we never see the communication between one neuron to another neuron. Okay, that is a problem. That is not a problem, actually it's an advantage, where we cannot see a communication between one neuron to another neuron. So we call it as, even it as a black box. Okay, so when I come to one more kind of technique, if you remember, we are studying all these techniques of data mining. We studied about decision tree, we studied about artificial neural networks, we studied about regression. Now when we come for unsupervised learning, you know what is the meaning of unsupervised learning? Where we are not going to consider past data more. Okay, we are going to only concentrate on the present data. But this supervised learning is nothing but where we are going to concentrate more on the past data. From this data, we are going to make some predictive models. From that models, we are going to try to find out decision trees, artificial neural networks. We can go for regression. But when I go for unsupervised data, where obviously we are going to take the present data. Okay, so when I go for cluster analysis, yeah, again it's an exploratory learning technique. Again, what it is going to do in a cluster, a group, cluster is basically what? It's a group where I am going to identify a set of similar groups in the data. Okay. In this technique, automatically identification of group, natural grouping takes place. How it is going to take place means, if suppose I am having 2 to 3 data nearby or similar, I am going to take them all and make one cluster. And some data we are very far and very different, we are going to make them one cluster. And there can be n number of the clusters, and that all clusters is going to be considered applied a logic of k-mean technique. Okay, under the guidance in selecting the right number of clusters in the data. You can see here, this may be a similar kind of data where I'm going to combine and make one cluster. There may be different kinds of data where I'm going to combine them in cluster. Okay, like this, I can combine more than different kinds of data as a one cluster, similar kind of a data in another cluster, apply the k-means, and I'm going to get the results. Okay, so this is how the things goes even in the cluster analysis. Then coming back to association rule. Okay, what is this association rule? Again, it's a popular data mining method. Basically, this method is used in big e-commerce websites. Why? Because whenever the word selling comes there, selling. Okay, this association rules is most used in the selling kind of business. Okay, so when I say selling kind of business, where the selling kind of business works more is nothing but e-commerce. E-commerce is the place where the selling business works more. And you believe me, the sites like Amazon.com and even your Netflix are going to use association rules. Okay, so what is this? What is this technique helps? The technique helps in finding the interesting relationships. Now, if people know, if people have searched some kind of a product, or even if you go for Netflix, people are seeing some action series. Second time, in association rule, in the bottom of the Netflix app, people can see, since you watched this kind of a serial, this kind of a series are also similar to it. Association, right? And if you watch some action movie, the next action movie very similar to that action movie is going to be displayed. Yes or no? Even in Amazon, if you search some kind of a product similar to that kind of a product, one more product is going to get you displayed. That is nothing but called as association. Okay, to help in interesting relationship between variables. Okay, so there may be any variable, either x is a different variable and y is a different variable, but using association rule, we can say x tends to y, where x and y are sets of data items. But there is some relationship, that relationship is going to be identified by means of an association rule. Okay, so yeah, that is a form of an unsupervised learning. You already seen there are two kinds of unsupervised learning. Okay, one is cluster analysis and then there is an association. Okay, so now what happens in case of unsupervised learning? It has no dependent variables and there are no right and wrong answer. There are just stronger and weaker relationships. That's all. Okay, people can see if there is a very strong relationship, it will display, or if there is a very weak relationship, it will display. That is how the association rules work. And you believe me, the e-commerce sites like Netflix and Amazon, they are very much using this kind of the association. Okay, so this is how the things goes, and that's what they are showing. X, they are the items. Okay, X, Y, maybe a milk, bread, milk, cheese, then comes butters. And if people know, those who are buying milk, cheese and butter, obviously they may buy the bread. That is how the association works. Okay. So coming back, there are a lot of tools and platforms for data mining. Okay. Some of the simple tools people can see, MS Excel. And even one more tool from IBM, we are going to call it as SPSS. Okay, IBM. They are very simple tools. Okay, simple end user data mining tool. You know about MS Excel. Again, it's a data mining tool, I can say. Because people can hold in Excel lot of data. And when you apply the filter, obviously you will get whatever you require. Okay, so one more is IBM SPSS. That is nothing but IBM statistical packages. Okay, when I come for standalone tool, the best example is ERP tools. Okay, when we go for open source, there are some tools like Weka. They are the open source tools. And when we are going to go for text-based tools, some GUI tools, okay, and then these are the different kinds of the tools that is going to be used in the data mining. Okay, so if we start to compare like Excel, IBM SPSS, and Weka, you know, Weka is a open source. Okay,
And what happens when I say ownership, everything is commercial. Okay, when I say data mining futures in case of Excel, it is limited. Why you know that 1,200 some thousand something rows and thousand something columns? The data mining feature is limited there. Okay, but it is extensive and it performs issue with large data. When I say standalone, yes, it is a standalone, but it is embedded in business intelligence and so on. Okay, when you go for user skills needed, yes, end user skill is needed. But here skilled business intelligence analyst is needed. Here we can use normal person, but here some business analyst is needed. Okay, so about user interface, yeah, select and click, very easy. But here it's a drag and drop option, and it is text output option. And when I go for data format, industry standard, yes, it is industry standard, but here it's a variety of data source, and this is appropriate. This is how the, when we go for comparison between data mining tools. Okay. Excel is also a data mining tool. IBM SPP is a data mining tool. Weka is a data mining tool. But basically, Weka is an open source. Okay, people try with that data tool. So when you come for some of the best practices, data mining is nothing but, when I say data mining, it should be always effective and successful. Why? Because we need two things when we are doing data mining. We should have an idea about the business and even technology. The business idea helps us to understand the domain and the key question. Okay, whereas technology helps how to clean the data, how to update the data, and how to assemble and use the data in the business problem. Okay, so even data mining industry has proposed a CRISP. Okay, what is the CRISP? Cross industry standard process. Okay, you will know Amazon is also one of the best example of CRISP. Okay. Cross industry standard process for data mining, and best thing what you can do in data mining is it's an iterative process, because keep on adding the data and filtering the data. It is best example is divide and conquer. Okay, what you need to do is first you need to divide, okay, smaller amount of data, and then you go for a problem solution which is very similar, then you conquer it. These are the things goes. And it has the CRISP has six essential steps. Okay, so this is a diagram of CRISP. What if people can use this business understanding? Okay, from their data understanding, data preparation, modeling, evaluation, deployment. Okay, these are the six steps that is present in cross industry standard process for data mining. Cross industry standard process for they are the best to practice the data mining process. This is like a recycle. Everything happens and you get whatever the data is, very clean data. Okay, this is the best practice. And some more best practices. The first and foremost thing, okay, one of the best practices, a good question. Okay, with a good business question, then only your answer may also get you good when you are doing data mining. So when I say 10,000 rupees phone in my Amazon, I may get a good results. I cannot say like 10,399. Then obviously there is a problem. I have to search the data. So where I cannot apply data mining properly. So the best thing is the question should be correct. Okay. And second is nothing but what a second important step is to be creative and open. Okay, and it should be imaginative. The third is the data should be clean and high quality. Okay. And the fourth is very much patience is required, because continuously data is coming and you are mining the data news. And simply yesterday I told you about gold mining. Okay, you doesn't get the gold within fraction of second. You should keep on digging on the earth. You should go up to, because I think everybody has seen KGF. Okay, the KGF movie where how I always tell you that Yash is going to dig everyone. Single-handedly fight 200-300 people, I think, in the whole movie. Okay, he also dig very well. So he earned very well. Finally, when I come here, very much his patience is required, because when you are doing data mining, you should dig your data very much. Then only you can get a clean data. Okay, and one should not accept what the data says at first. When I see the data looks good, then only I should not accept, because you may getting very good quality of the data in the upcoming days. Okay, so these are the very best practices, and there are some myths with respect to data mining. You know, what is the meaning of a merge? Merge is something like a old story. Okay, so what happens? Data mining is about algorithms, people say, but actually it is not. Data mining is part of an algorithm, but basically when you use data mining in the business, the question is first important. Based on the questions, you people can say whether you need to apply the algorithm or not. Okay, the second myth is data mining is about predictive accuracy. Yes, that is true. Okay, we can predict the accuracy in the data mining. The third is data mining requires a data warehouse. Okay, to extract the information. That is also true. And data mining requires large quantities of data, but this is not acceptable. Because you can do mining on small or medium sized data also. You cannot say I'm going to do the data mining only on 100 GB, 200 GB. If there is 5 GB of the data also, you can do the data mining. Okay. And data mining requires a technology expert. That is also acceptable, because if it is a Excel oriented data, anybody can do. But when you are working on open source like Vika, okay, and even IBM SPSS, then what happens? Data mining, okay. So there are many mistakes in the data mining. Okay, the first and foremost mistake is nothing but selecting the wrong problem. Okay, when you select the wrong problem, then whatever the work you do on the data mining, everything goes. Okay, and you should buried under mountain of data without clear metadata. Without clear metadata, you cannot go for data mining. And disorganized data mining, like unstructured data, is very difficult to do the data mining. Okay, if you doesn't have an insufficient business knowledge, then better you don't go for data mining. Okay, incompatibility of data mining tools. No, we doesn't know about Vika, and we cannot say working on data mining. Okay, and even looking only at aggregated results, again that's a problem. Running out of time, you cannot do this data mining in fraction of seconds. But still some of the tools are there, but tools always give you predictive result. Initially people used to do the data mining based on some manual work. Today everything is automated. Okay, so I will always tell you Trivago. Trivago is one more example for a data mining, because Trivago can search the hotel out of all over the world. Even I can search the hotel in America, London, New York, everywhere, right? So can you believe me, what is the algorithm they have written? Data mining algorithm, which can filter your data within fractions. That's the beauty of the data mining. Okay, so when we come for data visualization, okay, what is the meaning of data visualization? Data seeing. Here basically, when I say, can you see the data? People may say, yes, it is a hard copy or a soft copy, we can see the data. But actually in the companies, they are going to measure the data in terms of a graph. Okay, they were not going to say, I have seen the data, hard copy of the data, soft copy of the data, no. Okay, they can say only one thing, there is nothing but they are going to represent the data in terms of graphs. Okay, so when I say data visualization, they can be shown and even reveal the data. Basically that data should tell a story. Obviously, when I put a graph, it's going to tell me some kind of a story. Okay, induce the viewer of thinking the substance of the data. Avoid distorting what the data have to say. Okay, make large set of coherent. Okay, fine. We are going to see different kinds of charts in the graph, which is going to help us to see the data visualization. When I say line graph, this is a basic and most popular type of displaying information. And it basically it shows a data as series of points that is going to be connected and make a straight line. Okay, so this is one more chart. And when there's a scatter plot, this is another very basic and useful graph, you know about it. It helps the relationship between two variables, right? Now it's a max marks and this is English marks. Both are subjects, but it is going to represent the relationship between these two variables. Okay, in this question they got 20 here, 20, 40 like this. Okay. So when I say bar graph, a bar graph shows thin colorful rectangular bars with their length being proportional to the values represented. Okay. Proportional to the values represented. Okay. So we are having 10 minutes of time. What a problem we are going to finish. When I say stacked bar graph, okay, these are the particular methods of doing bar graphs where the value of multiple variables are stacked one on the other. See here, multiple variables, plotted. There are different kinds of products. Okay, all stacked over one another. We call it as a stacked bar graph. And you know about histogram. These are like a bar graph, except that they are useful in showing data frequencies or data values. Okay. When I say pie chart, you know about it, pie chart. Okay, this is a very popular tool, kind of a data visualization to show the distortion of variables such as sales by region. Okay, different sales based on the regions. When I say box chart, I think this kind of the graph you are seeing for the first time, where these are the special form of a chart to show the distribution of variables. Okay, the box shows in the middle half and the values while on the rest of the part. Okay, box will be in the middle part. The lines will be in the rest of the part. We call such a chart as a box chart. And some bubble graph. Okay, this is one more kind of a type of a chart where an interesting way of displaying multiple dimensions in one chart. Okay, this is about, if you can say mass 20, when I say mass is 20, this is small graph. 35, the bubble is little big. 50, the bubble is more big. Okay, this is how you can use bubble. And people can see this is like a speedometer, dials, we call it as a dials, and similar to speed dial in the car. Okay, that show whether the variable value is low, medium or high. Obviously it is in the range of 0 to 23, we can say low, 23 to 46, up to 65 medium, 65 and above high. Under such a scenario, in order to display the visualization of the data, we can use dials. It is called as a dial. See, it's a very useful information. Basically, people have seen only some part of the charts, like bar graph, pie graph, okay, some line graph. Maximum you have seen up to what I have said, pie chart. But basically, whenever you go for a company, everybody, they are not going to show the data like this. They are only going to show the data in terms of a chart. By seeing the chart, you should understand the amount of data. Okay, so then comes the geographical data maps. Since people see Amazon is somewhere, people can see where are the data centers of Amazon. They are going to geographically show in this continent, in this continent, there are the data centers of Amazon. Right? So geographically data maps are being to be shown. Okay, this is called as geographical chart. Okay. So basically, it's all the different kinds of the charts. Pie, polar, bubble, scatter, you have seen already, line, bar, area, especially if it represents an area, Gantt chart. This is the guy who is very, very famous, Gantt chart. Okay. And these are the different kinds of the charts that is used in order to display the information in the, what I can say, information about the data. Okay. So you people can say, yes, I'm having 10 GB of the data. Then I may ask how the utilization of 10 GB is there. Can you visualize me? Then you cannot say just in words, 5 GB is used here, 2 GB is used here, 3 GB is used there. Like, so what you can do is, the best thing is you can apply the chart, any one of the chart to display the information. This is going to give you the meaningful information to understand where all the data is utilized. Right? So this is how we are going to utilize the display the visualization of the charts. Okay, so with this, we are going to complete the third module of your business intelligence, data warehouse, data mining, and data visualization. Okay, so don't worry about the notes. Okay, I'm going to get you the notes. And what I would like to tell you today is nothing but I have uploaded MCQ. Okay, kindly check your concept and try to upload the 15 questions. Try to upload, okay, in your portal, which I have already uploaded in my Moodle. Okay, so with this, so you people get some marks. As you people already written the assignment, many of you submitted. Okay, I am getting the count of 107. I don't know who is not submitted, because I am going to scrutinize the risk. Then I will come to know if you are not submitted, kindly submit the assignment at the earliest. Okay. So with this, your marks is getting secured for your internals. That is for assignment and MCQs. Okay, rest theory internals, the guidelines will come from the higher authority. Okay. So is there any doubts in today's class what we have done? See, we have done, basically you have studied here, it is very, very important is data warehouse and data mining. Okay, and all the techniques in data mining. It may be a regression technique, association rule, it may be a cluster technique, or it may be what I can say, a decision tree. Basically, decision tree is very, very important, or it may be addition rule. All these techniques are very, very important. And when we go for displaying the data, data visualization, we call it as. Whenever we go for data visualization, all the charts are very, very important. Okay, it may be a pie chart, it may be a bar chart, it may be a bubble chart, it may be a scatter chart. Any of the chart, all the charts are mm-hmm. Okay. So with this, let us conclude today's class. Okay. Any doubts? Mm-hmm. Okay. So let us finish this up. And guys, when somebody left the class faculty, if you become the host, kindly give the authority of the host.
Sir.
Yeah. Kindly give the host authority to the faculty. And then you can leave. Okay. Please do that. Right, like today's, if the problem happens, it is very difficult. I think Kiran didn't join again. Okay, not a problem. Is there any doubts today's class? Nothing? Okay. Okay, thank you guys. Thank you very much. That's fine.